Hi, welcome to another episode of This Is My Architecture. I'm David John, and I have with me Swaroop from FPL Technologies. Hi, Swaroop. Welcome to the show.
Hello, David. Thank you for inviting me.
So let's get started. Tell us something about FPL Technologies.
Well, FPL Technologies is on a mission to reimagine credit card and payments from first principle, and we at FPL are building a mobile-first credit card in India. We have two amazing applications, that is OneScore and OneCard, and we have about millions of customers for each of the apps.
Wonderful. So what do we have here? What does this platform do?
Well, this platform is all about how we can build on-demand, serverless, and secure ML workbenches, because this is the platform that is used by our data scientists to ingest, process, and transform large volumes of data. The transformed data is then used by our rule engines to perform critical business decisioning. Prior to this platform, since we are scaling rapidly in terms of customer and internal teams, we always used to face problems like infrastructure management, resource allocation, and most of all, security. Well, this platform solves all of the problems for us.
Impressive. You seem to have solved some key challenges frequently faced by data scientists. So let's dive a bit deeper. How does a data scientist interact with this platform?
Well, a data scientist typically prepares a Jupyter notebook. And this Jupyter notebook basically ingests some raw data, applies some transformation, and using machine learning models, it generates some scores and labels. Now, let's say a data scientist wants to run this notebook inside the SageMaker Studio. They can simply log into the studio using the appropriate IAM role. Now, different user groups are there inside the SageMaker Studio domain. The data scientist needs to identify which user groups he or she is suitable to log in with. Now, once the user logs in into the SageMaker Studio, the next they need to specify what is the instance size they want and what are the job-specific parameters. And then, when we are done with that, they can submit for a processing job. Now, once the request goes for a processing job, the request actually comes to a Lambda, which in turn calls the ECR, where we have our containers. So from the ECR repository, we fetch a custom container that contains all the libraries that are pre-installed and that are necessary for the notebook to complete till execution. We also use PaperMill that allows us to inject parameters into the notebooks on a dynamic basis. So the output of this processing jobs is directly dumped into a data lake in S3.
Impressive automation, I should say. So we use SageMaker Studio, SageMaker Processing Jobs, Lambda, and IAM to provide a scalable, secure, and isolated ML workbenches for your data scientists. I assume the SageMaker Processing Jobs uses the data from your data lake. Can you talk a little bit about your data lake? How it is hydrated, and how do you enforce data access controls?
So yes, we have S3 as a data lake, and our data is coming in from Amazon RDS, our data is coming in from the BigQuery, our data is stored in Kinesis streams. Now, all of this data is actually funneled through our glue jobs, which are essentially PySpark job that anonymizes, transforms, and all the synthesized data is stored into S3 as domain-specific data marts. Now we dump all the data into S3, which is our data lake. One important thing to note here is that we do keep our data lake ACID compliant, so we use Apache Hadoop to ensure that our RDS and data lake are in sync. As a fintech company, security is a very big concern for us, and we try to harden it wherever possible. On a primary layer, everything inside the SageMaker is running inside our own VPC. Now, this VPC is our own private VPC with a very controlled egress and ingress. On a secondary level, we have IAM, where we have specified separate execution rules for different data science user group. So for example, we have data science user group 1, where the user group 1 can only access the data of customer, and we have data science user group 2, where the user group 2 can only access the data of application. Now, creating separate execution rules for each of these data science user groups allows us to invoke a sense of workspace isolation, which helps us harden our security.
Makes sense on how you've used S3 and RDS as your data stores, and also how you've leveraged IAM to enforce your data access controls. So what were some key challenges you faced, and how does this platform address them?
Well, the first key challenge was security, because prior to this architecture, we only used to have a single SageMaker notebook instances. And as we kept on scaling, multiple data scientists joined us, and they logged on to the same notebook instances. So there was absolutely no workspace isolation. Moreover, there was resource starvation due to so much traffic on a single notebook instance. So this architecture allows us to run our notebooks as SageMaker processing jobs, which brings in the much more required agility, along with security, scale, and an on-demand infrastructure. We need not worry about the instances because instances are created and torn down on the fly. Moreover, this also comes with a UI that empowers our data scientists to run their data pipelines on production workloads without the help of any infrastructure engineer. With the adoption of this architecture, I think 75% of our workloads are now running inside SageMaker Studio's processing jobs. And this is looking really well for us because we were able to launch a lot of customer-facing and as well as internal product way sooner than planned.
That's a great story. Thank you, Swaroop, for being here on the show. Thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.